Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to talk about change detection in Angular. Let's start. What is change detection? Change detection is the ability to detect changes. It is the backbone of the Angular framework. I have created an Angular application to explain about change detection. Here, let me create a variable called counter. And let me bind that and show it in the view. Now, let me create a button and add a click event. Let me bind this event to a function. And inside that function, let me increase this variable. Now we can see the value in the view is also updated. This is because of the change detection mechanism. Change detection in Angular makes sure that the data in the component and the view are always in sync with each other. The part of the Angular framework responsible for this is called the change detector. Every component has a change detector that reads the binding on the template and makes sure that the data model and view are in sync with each other. We know that we can use ng-docheck lifecycle hook to hook into and run any code whenever change detection runs. So let me implement docheck interface and put a console.log inside ng-docheck method. Now if I click the button, we can see the change detection runs. Let's see another example. Let me move this code inside a setInterval function. And let me click the button. We can see the counter is getting updated every second. I have a question here. Previously, whenever we clicked the button, because of the click event, the change detection happened. But now, the data is getting updated during runtime. Here also, we can see the view is getting updated and we can see the change detection is running. So who is informing Angular to check for changes? Think about another scenario. You are clicking a button to get data from database. That is also going to be an asynchronous operation. So you may get the response anytime. But after some time, when we get the response, the view will be updated with the data. So who is informing Angular about the arrival of data? There is something called ng-zone in Angular whose responsibility is to inform Angular about any asynchronous operations. So Angular runs change detection because of three reasons. Whenever an event like click, submit, etc. happens. Whenever an asynchronous functions like setInterval or setTimeout gets executed. And whenever an API request is invoked. Also, we need to understand each component in Angular has its own change detector. Assume we have an application in which we have a component structure like this. This is called component tree. So each component has its own change detector. So this is going to be the corresponding change detector tree for this component tree. And Angular always runs the change detection from top to bottom in the component tree. Even if an event gets fired in any child component, Angular always runs the change detector from the root component. Let me show you that. I have created another Angular application and I am having the same component structure. And I have implemented docheck in all the components and I am having a button in each component. So you can see this. Now if I click any button, for example, if I click the parent 1 child 2 button, we can see these console logs. Here you can see the change detection in the root component runs first and then in the parent 1 and parent 2. And then in parent 1 child 1, then in parent 1 child 2. And after that in the other two components in order. Even if I click any other button, the order is not going to change. So it is clear. For a single event somewhere in the application, Angular runs the change detector for all the components. So you may get a question in your mind whether it is going to affect the performance. Actually, it is not, because it is a unidirectional flow from root to bottom. And after a single pass, the change detection tree gets stable. As every component has its own change detector, JavaScript virtual machine can optimize it for better performance. We have already seen due to three reasons, Angular checks each component in the application. But there is a way to reduce the number of checks and we can avoid running the change detector for the whole subtree. To optimize the number of checks, Angular provides two change reduction strategies, default strategy, on-push strategy. Whatever we have seen so far is the default strategy. Here, when there is an event happening, change reduction runs in all the components from top to bottom. If you feel even for one event, Angular runs the change reductor for the whole tree, you can avoid it for a particular component and its subtree by setting change reduction strategy to on-push. Let me explain this. In the parent one, child one component, let me create an empty array, and on button click, let me push a string inside. In the HTML, let me use ng4 to show the data we pushed. And I am also using @input decorator and pass the data from parent one component. So that we can push data from the same component as well as from the parent component. And so we can see it is working. Now let me change the change reduction strategy in the parent one child one component to on push. We can change that by using the change reduction property inside the @component declarator, like this. Now let me try to push from both the components. When I push from the same component, we can see it is working. But when I push from the parent component, we can see it is not working. That is because when we push from the same component, the click event in that component is invoking a change reduction, and so the view is getting refreshed. But when I push from the parent component, there is no event happening. Also, as I have set the strategy as onPush, the change reduction is not happening. If I have not used the on-push strategy, change reduction would have occurred as part of the default strategy. Let me console log this inside the do check so that it will be more clear. When I click the button with the child, we can see we have one data. When I click second time, we can see we have two data. Now let me click the button in the parent. We can see we have three data now, but it is not refreshed in the view. If I click two more times, we can see we have five data, but it is not shown in the view yet. If I click the button in the child, we can see we have 6 data now, and as that click event triggers a change reduction, all 6 data is shown in the view now. When we set the change reduction strategy as on push, and for some reason, if we want to trigger change reduction, we can do it manually. There are a few options available like using the mark for check, deduct changes, detach, reattach, etc. For now, let me use the deduct changes method. And so we can see, even though we have set change reduction strategy as on push, we can see change reduction is running. Hope you understood about change reduction. Please like this video, subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.